Hello and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft, and welcome to my series Kemper Camp. And today, as you can see, it's a very nice weather. It's about 7 degrees Celsius, so it's quite warm here. There's a little bit wind, but I'm protected by the hill that is behind me, so it's very nice to be here today. I just got out here to relax and do some stuff, maybe build that little backrest I have been talking about. I think I'll do that. And then I have been out and bought something, and I would like to show you that. First of all, I bought this. And what is this? Well, you'll see in a minute. And then, as I have been very lucky because I found this. And I'll show you that in detail too. So, and beside that, I have some other stuff that I have bought so I can make a raised bed. Many of you subscribers have advised me to make a raised bed, and I think it's a good idea. Inside my lavabo, there's not water coming in, so it's not because of that, but because then I can use that raised bed as a bench I can sit on when I'm in the lavabo. If it's raining outside or I can't stay outside, then I can sit on that. So, because this little forest, there's not a lot of trees I can use for that. So I've been out and bought some spruce poles that I can make this raised bed on. I don't know if I'm going to make that today, perhaps. I can start it. So, but now I would like to show you the things I've bought in detail. So hang on. Yeah, and first I would like to show you this. It's called a Scotch Eye Auger, and it's for drilling holes in timber and wood in general. I made this myself, and you saw me use it when I built up my fire pit. With the pole, I made some holes for the chains. So this one I made myself. I had this for a very long time. I even think I have got it from my father-in-law, who died for many years ago, and just put a handle on it. I made it flat here, and well, I just pulled that down. It's very steady. But this one, you can see there's a hole here, and I have to make a handle, a piece of wood that I can go through this, and then I can make holes with this. I'm very excited because it was very hard to find such a tool, and I actually had to buy this in the USA. And of course, I put a link below so you can see where I bought it. I bought it on eBay, and today I'm going to make a handle and perhaps begin using it. But the most exciting thing I bought is this. And it's a box saw. These leather straps I made myself, so I have a hole on it. It doesn't come with this, but anyhow, you can use different things to get a system like this. But see here, pull this through. And this is what you get, yeah. And many of you have already guessed that it is a box saw. And you can see here, there's a saw blade inside. When it's locked, it is hidden, so you can't hurt yourself. And what is really cool about this saw is it's hole inside, so inside I have an extra blade, and this blade is for wet wood, fresh wood, and this one is for dry wood. So this blade can stay inside here, and this one I had to like this, and then I just turn this. keep on turning until it's completely. This has to be very tight. Something like that. So, here you can see, and of course, I'm going to use it today. I have to try it out. This one is made of oak. It was a challenge to find a box saw that is made of wood. I found a place in the USA, America, but every time I get things from the USA, it costs me a lot of money in custom duties. So I found this on eBay. A guy in Great Britain, England, who's called Les, and he's a very nice guy, and he makes very, very fine saws. And of course, I put a link below so you can see where I bought it, and you can have it in other types of wood, but I prefer this in oak. So now I'm going to try it out and see how it works. So hang on. Yeah, and here you can see the poles that I have bought, spruce poles, that is going to be my raised bed, the thing I'm laying on. And I have to cut some larger logs for the foundation of this raised bed. So that is what I'm going to do now, and I'll do that on the same tree that I used to my block where I can process my firewood. Voila. And now one more of these. And I would like to show you what I'm having for lunch. This is something that is really Danish. This is rye bread, and here in Denmark we eat a lot of that, and it's very healthy. And inside this little sandwich, oh, it's hard to see, but here there is some we call leverpostej, and it's something similar to pâté, pâté made of liver. And and inside I have some salami, Danish salami, which is very tasteful together with leverpostej. And it is something that is 100% Danish, and it tastes delicious. And also a Danish beer called Royal Classic. It's a very good beer. And I can tell you so much, this is life. Well, if I can live this away every day, that would be so good.
Really, really warm today, the sun.
Now I finished. As you can see, I can use two hands or one hand. I think I'm going to make some kind of leather purse or bag where I can have these two parts in. That would be cool.
Now I'm finished for today. I have to drive home. I put one in and going to make more up so I have a back rest. I think it's coming up nicely. And I'm looking forward to have such thing I can rest my back. Well folks, this was all for today. I hope you enjoyed this little video and my series Kimber Camp. Next time I'm coming to the camp, and I hope it'll be next weekend, I'll finish my backrest chair and begin to make my race bed, I think so. So now the sun is still shining, but there's a little shadow here because of the high trees, and it's beginning to be a little cold. So I'm heading home now and put my video up this evening, Sunday evening. I hope you enjoy. Thank you again for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I really appreciate that very much. And I hope to see you again on my next video. Bye bye and take care.